presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, look who we have. It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We got taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy camo! I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Always do your best. Practice makes the master. By doing your best over and over again, you can master the art of transformation. By doing your best, the habits of misusing your word, taking things personally, and making assumptions will become weaker and less frequent with time. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 171, NASDAQ up 140, S&P's up 32, gold contract down $3, trading $17.34 an ounce, silver. Up 6 cents, $17.55 an ounce. Light sweet crude, up 71 cents, $36.97 a barrel. Notes and bonds. 10-year note right now, flat, 138.23. 30-year bond up 2 ticks at 177.08 and King Dollar. King Dollar's trading down 630 ticks, 96.690. The euro is at 113. The yen is at 107.36, and the British pound is at 125 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. Quite a day out here, folks. Quite a 24 hours, actually. Quite a, from 6 o'clock last night. So if we take a look at this E-mini, what you're going to see out here inside the E-mini, it opens back up 6 o'clock Sunday night. Bottom line is that we had opened last night at 29.92. By 2 o'clock in the morning, Eastern Standard Time, you are down to 29.35. And from that particular point on, folks, this market's been clawing all the way back. Now, that being said, just as I was just talking about in the news update, we are at we hit 3,079. The sell on Friday started happening at the 3,087. We go take a look at the S&P. The SPY, this is. We take a look at the SPY. What you're going to see out here is that on a technical basis, what you've done is that you've come right back to where we broke topside from. You're going to have lighter volume, and you did reject price. That's the real bottom line. When we broke topside, folks, you broke topside on the 18th of May. That low there is 292.70. The high is 296.75. And guess where we went, folks? We went to 296.74. The real kicker here is going to be, can this hold coming into the close? That's going to be the number. It certainly has had a gain in an extraordinary way on a 24-hour basis. That's kind of how this market is shooken out at this particular point. It was the NDX 100 again that basically dragged the S&P up in a monster way. You had the 3Qs trade down to 231.47. And the break topside was 228.68. So what the NDX 100 also did, bottom line, rejected lower price, is much stronger than the S&P for sure. And it doesn't look to me that the, let's go take a look at the future market inside the NQs and see where we're at. So look at that. Oh, this is interesting, man. We're at the same spot. Yeah, we're at the same spot. So the NQs on Friday, where the sell down happened, was 98.49, and we've hit 98.10. So coming into the next 60 minutes is going to be a big deal as to can Number one, the market get up those on the NQs, I believe that's about 40 points. On the S&Ps, it's about 10 points. Can it get up to that level to see whether those sellers are still laying out at that level? Gold contract, rejected lower price, had lighter volume. Gold wants higher price. We'll get over to the dollar. This is going to be about the dollar. Bottom line is that we had gold trade down to 1706 today. You've had 190,000 contracts. I believe we're going into 240. You're going into a big number here. 270. You went up to 270. It rejected it. Gold still in an ABC structure on the way up. That has a price projection of the 1821 to approximately 1825. We take a look at the silver market. What you have in silver? Silver had a huge rejection of lower price. We went silver traded down to 1701. And we did out here 72,000 contracts. I think you're going into 98. You're going into a big number. Yeah, you're going to 80 and 91. So silver also rejected lower price. And when you do look at the aspect of whether it's the gold or the silver equities out here today also rejected lower price. You had Hecla get down to 279. Right now you're trading at 311. If you go take a look at First Majestic was down there at 846. You're out here now at 913. You can go through a slew of them. And what they have all done is that they all did reject lower price. They had lighter volume. They're back inside the range right now, and they want higher price. King dollar. This is the number, folks, okay, because fast currency moves are always a little bit dangerous for the market. What you had last week is this. We got down to a price point of 95.716, and what that was, folks, is that that was the high of the lows that were established in March. It rejected that lower price. Bottom line, you had a two-day bounce. Today, giving it all back in spades. So I expect what you're going to see first is that you're going to make a run once again for this March 9th swing low. The top of that swing low is 95.788. The bottom is 94.895. You could very well have a monster ABC structure on the way down, too. And if that's what you got, then we're dealing with a, let's see, almost a buck. You're dealing with about four. Well, that still only puts you to the bottom. So if this is an ABC down, it still only gets you down to that 94.650 mark. What I do expect we're going to see is that you're going to get an aspect that more than likely is going to try to build cars to get into the 94. If you break the 94, then you have some real problems because the level under the 94, folks, okay, happens to be an 88. And an 88 is a big number. What we have seen the metals, they continue to hold. They've been in a consolidation now since April 7th. That's a very long consolidation. What has happened each time it goes to the top of the consolidation, it can't handle price. Each time it goes down to the bottom of the consolidation, there's no more sellers. The bull or bear is going to win. Someone's going to win it out. Today, folks, the bull won it out. Stay right there, folks. Come right back with our man, Mr. Dave Mazza, who's the managing director and head of product at Direction. Dow right now up 184, NASDAQ up 146, S&P's up 33. We'll come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up about 192, Nasdaq up 147, S&Ps are up 34. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Dave Mazza. Dave is the managing director, head of product, folks, at Direction. And don't forget, they got a lot of great information at their website, folks. As you're sitting on our website right now, you can just hit the banner, or you can go to Direction, and Direction is spelled D-I-R-E-X-I-O-N. You're going to see a huge amount of information, great information, whether you're a bull or a bear. And we're going to start the conversation off with Dave, too, today about real estate. Dave Mazza, welcome back to TFNN.
Hey, thanks for having me back.
Hey, I love what you have on this front page here. You know what's interesting, Dave? We're all in the equity market, of course, okay? But because a majority of people do own houses, if they don't, they're renting. You know, we get a lot of calls on real estate. In particular, in this area, meaning the last 2.5 months, because I don't think anyone has a real good handle on what way real estate's going to go. You know what I mean? In general.
Well, exactly. It's one of those sectors right now that has a lot of controversy associated with it, for good reason, because of all the uncertainties with this virus. But on one hand, if you look at just the pure housing data, it looks phenomenal. Looks excellent.
It does.
So that's your bull case. On the other hand, if you think about the property markets, especially from a commercial perspective, do companies continue to have work-from-home policies if they are even continuing operating? So is that going to put pressure on commercial real estate? But what this does is has made an interesting setup, you know, for the bulls and bears here in some of our real estate and home builder ETFs.
It does. So if you had mentioned it last time we were on, you mentioned Nail. Now, this is really cool. If you can explain to the folks, first off, what the what is inside Nail, okay? And that's the symbol, folks, N-A-I-L. It's the Daily Direction Home Builders Bull Position.
Yeah, that's right. So what you're going to find, it's a 3x leverage product.
Yes.
But what's inside there, what's driving performance up or down on any given day, is your large home builders and then some of your kind of home building plus companies. So supplies and things of that.
Right.
And again, what we've seen is Nail's been an ETF that we've had around for some time, but only recently, frankly, because of the performance, have we seen people really move into the product. So it's one of our real bright spots for new interest that has come this year from traders.
Yeah, and folks, it's a highly liquid product, which is so cool. I mean, this equity is doing 2 to 3.5 million shares a day, and you get every large builder in it. You get Sherwin-Williams in it. I mean, if you really want to understand the building business in general, you're going to see all of those. Now, the Drive, DRV, talk to me about that one, because I can't figure out what's in that one.
So that is what I'll call kind of your pure play real estate company. So it's mostly REITs.
Right? I
see. There are some associated names in there. Oh. So the two funds are related, right? The home builders on one hand, and then the real estate. But, you know, one's really the input, one's the output. So, you know, real estate's a sector which has a lot of episodic volatility. And now more recently, we're seeing that come into play. So we're seeing, you know, that fund really latch on as well.
Now, that's really cool, man, because I can see, and this, and folks, what's important here is to always understand what you're trading, what is inside of these, okay? Because I can see that, Dave, because then we'd have to figure out, like, what's in the REITs also, right? I mean, you know, we have a lot of different types of REITs, right?
Yeah, exactly. And so there, you know, it's a push-pull because you get some REITs that are mall REITs, office REITs.
Sure.
Some own data centers now with the growth of 5G and cloud computing and things like that. So it's a diverse mix of REITs that are going to drive performance on that fund on any given day.
Now, and when we talk real estate, folks, okay, one of the reasons that I think a lot of us, you know, and believe me, you know, we're all kind of in the real estate business because, of course, we have houses. The interest rate, we know the structure has been great. You know, we had a break downtown a couple weeks ago, and then all of a sudden, man, the note and bond market just loves to come right back again. So talk to me about your interest rate products inside the note and bond market.
You know, TMV, TMF, those products provide direct exposure to an index of treasury bonds, in that case, long-term bonds.
Right.
So as the long bond moves up and down, it's a way for traders to amplify both their bull and bear positions. And, what we've seen with rates, you know, rates have, other than, you know, to your point, some of the wobbles, you know, they've been pointing toward a very bearish picture of the economy, one where growth is slow to emerge. Of course, you know, the equity bulls are saying the opposite there, which is, I think, really interesting about the macro setup here. But what traders can do is use TMF and use TMV to directly make those decisions about whether interest rates are going to move higher or lower, and do so with an amplified exposure to that basket of 20-plus treasury bonds.
Nice. So what we're going to do now is that we have to go to the small caps. Yeah. And Dave's going to be smiling, folks, because we're all going to be smiling, actually, because if you remember, when we go back about 5 or 6 years, if you've traded this direction product, whether it's the TNA or the TZA, these were some of the coolest things to trade because the small caps would move. And all of a sudden, Dave, I think the small caps like took some vitamins a couple weeks ago, man. We're getting movement both ways now.
Yeah, today's a really interesting example. So even when the broader market was down, small caps were outperforming by a lot.
Yes.
Today, the drivers of small caps are a lot of these, for small caps, larger names. So I'm thinking $2 billion plus biotech companies. And because of some of the idiosyncratic nature of the small cap space, especially with the overload of biotech and health and some of the healthcare names and then the financials, a day like today, and what we've seen the setup get a lot better for small caps. Small caps never, you know, they peaked a couple of years ago,
right?
Not more recently. So they've been out of favor. Traders, again, are looking at TNA and TZA in particular now because small caps, to your point, you know, they've taken their vitamins, they're getting some life back. Today, again, really interesting for me is we're seeing divergence where small caps are leading large caps, but value stocks are lagging growth stocks. Usually what we've been seeing lately is the small cap over large relationship and value over growth really be one trade. It's basically economies reopening or not, right? When we see cyclicals rally. But what's interesting, and maybe it's the intersection of a greater number of retail investors, we've seen the growth of trading platforms, cyclicals are coming back from a trading perspective in a really interesting way. And small caps is a place where people shouldn't ignore it even if it hasn't been on their radar for the last couple of years.
And folks, you just heard Dave. Go over to direction.com. There's a huge amount of information that's free every single day. I got to tell you, Dave, man, it blows my mind how much you have to know being the director of a product putting this together. But what I've found is that your website has got extraordinary, man. I mean, in a big way. And you'll see what I'm talking about, folks, when you go over there. I mean, it's really freaking cool, man. I mean, there's stuff on there, you know, very quick that you can kind of, you know, get that notes of as to what's going on in a sector, man. So I think you guys are doing a great job, man.
No, we appreciate that feedback. We just launched that new website really less than 2 weeks ago. So yeah, I want to everyone, please go feel free to check it out. There's tons of educational material on there. Sign up for newsletters and everything to meet your inbox.
It's a big one, Dave. Thank you so much, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. We look forward to speaking to you 2 weeks from today, Dave.
Thank you.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hanks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market, Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour, Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m., Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m., and Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now up 74, Nasdaq's up 115, S&Ps are up 21. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 30 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day at TFNN. 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Very easy to get, folks. You're on our website right now. Just go right to the top of the featured content. You're going to see Mastering Probability. You hit Mastering Probability. You just hit subscribe. You can get Mastering Probability delivered to your doorstep every morning, bright and early. It's only $149 a month. If you want to get it for 6 months at $695, which is a savings of $199 at 22%. You can get it for a year, folks, for $1,195, which is a savings of almost $600, and you save 33%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. He's got some great archives out there. You want to understand the tools that he used, get over there. He was the number one market timer in 2018, the number two market timer in 2019. The bottom line, check it out. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, you know, just trying to get back to normal, you know, as things open up. You know, our coastline, our coast between Broward, Dade, Palm Beach, we're behind you guys. But I did hear this morning, I think I caught a segment of your show where you said that you're starting to have a little bit of a breakout area in St. Pete.
A bummer. Yeah, it's a big bummer. Man, right where our office is, folks, from the second block to the 24th block, figure it's a grid, huge problem, man. The bars opened Friday. Saturday, three of them had a shutdown. It was just like that. It was that quick. And what I'm worried about actually is that...
Have you been venturing out yourself much?
You know, I have.
No, that's cool.
So, I'm careful and all this, but it's such a shame because, you know, we're all in business. And what I'm really feeling for folks is that, you know, they had a shutdown. Then, okay, save some money, you get some money, you can open back up again. And this is like a disaster. And what we do know from, you know, hanging out is that bar people hang together. And I'm just thinking, you know what, man, they must have been hanging in the same place. Because what are the odds that three different bars within 20 blocks, you know what I'm saying? So
yes, it's, yes.
And because you guys had a lot worse than us, but this hit quick. Let's hit quick.
We've been going out too, you know, trying to find some sense of normal, being
right.
Safe and smart like you are. But here, when we go to the restaurants, we're still at 25% capacity. So, you know, we're primarily going to the restaurants that we have been going to just to try to support the ownership groups there. But, you know, I've become friends with the ownership groups. When I speak to them, one restaurant, they've run out of their PPP money, so now they're starting to furlough more employees. You know, another company, another entity, we spoke to them on a Saturday night, and, I mean, they're losing money. They're just open. They're losing money. They're going to try to stick it out.
But, you've had plenty of businesses. We both know. This is not, you know, this is like a disaster, man.
It is.
Yeah.
It is. Yeah, yeah.
Right, cool.
So let's talk about the markets just for a bit here. And obviously stay safe over there. Just be outdoors. This virus doesn't live outdoors.
There's no doubt.
Stay on
the
beach.
Florida. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I thought what we do here, Tom, because, you know, especially today's activity, really interesting. How do we analyze this? What does it mean out here? So the first charts that we're looking at, because everybody can do this at home, I've got the diamonds, the spies, the Qs, and the IWM. So the first thing to understand is a bullish market or a market that breaks out would be always trading above the high of the prior year. So notated here, you can see the 2019 highs, and this shows you the different market that we have. So when we take a look at, for example, the Qs are above their 2019 high, which was 216.16. But when it comes to the diamonds, when it comes to the spies, if you take a look at last week, that rally before price was given up made it all the way back, in essence, to that 2019 high at that 324.89 level, just slightly underneath it.
Yes.
Not by much. And the IWM. So when we do take a look at markets, when you and I and everybody are analyzing markets, the Qs are their total own separate deal because of this total paradigm shift inside the market that we're seeing out here, technology driven. So what I've seen take place today, with the exception of the Qs, is just a counter trend rally in the other indices. Let me show you and the other folks listening why I have that conclusion and the things to take a look at. So, for example, in the S&P 500, this is our this is a chart. This is a tool that takes a look at each of the components inside the S&P 500. And what it does is it provides us with the number of issues that are trading above the top of their profile. Now, folks, the top of a profile is resistance. So picture yourself driving down the road. Once you get through resistance, you can floor it. And, you know, you're off to your next resistance point, wherever that might be. Inside the that's represented by the green line. The red line represents the number of issues that are trading below the bottom of the box. So specifically, there's 91 21 instruments in the S&P 500 that have a bullish bias, price above the top of the daily profile.
Yes.
188 instruments are trading below the bottom of the profile. So I don't want folks to get too sucked into the price movements that we see here. Continuing to move higher with bearish market breadth is a tough thing to do over time. So we've got the bearish crossover. That took place last week. I did mention that the Qs are their own separate animal. So let's take, and they're obviously much stronger. But if we take a look at the daily market breadth again for the NASDAQ 100, we still have a bearish crossover here as well. So even as well as it's doing, there are 20. Now, this is close. There's 27 instruments that are trading above the top of their profile, Tom.
Okay.
And 32 below the bottom. Nonetheless, still a bearish crossover here. So market breadth is important. That's for the S&P and for the NASDAQ. We can also take a look at market breadth for the New York Stock Exchange. And we do that, or I do that, through the Advanced Decline Oscillator. Now, the Advanced Decline Oscillator, folks, it's taking the Advanced Decline Line, and it's developing the difference between the 19 and the 39-day exponential moving average. Gives us a ratio. Right now, the ratio is reading minus 16 point something, because these numbers are going to change. It's below zero. And when it's below zero, this tells us that sellers are in control of the marketplace. And it's been below zero for about 3 or 4 days. So when I take a look at market breadth for the S&P on its daily time frame and the NASDAQ 100, and then I take a look at New York Stock Exchange, everything here points to today just being a counter trend rally. Other things that we have. So I've talked about the market profiles. If we take a look at market profiles, the ES Mini is trading below the bottom of its box. It would need to trade above 3154 in order to flip the switch back to bullish. The NASDAQ, that's the animal. And so the S&P or ES Mini has given us a change in trend signal. So has the Dow equity future contract. So has the Russell 2000. It's the NQ that hasn't. And it's still fine support at the bottom of its daily profile, which is 95.59. And that's the price level that if we start seeing two closes, consecutive closes, below 95.59, the NASDAQ will not be able to hold the market up any longer. Now, I expect the decline in the NASDAQ to not be as substantial as that inside the Dow and the Russell 2000, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. But we have signals today. We have to use the information that's available to us now. We have something different tomorrow at this time, then we'd make a different call. But what I want folks to know right now is this rally, based upon market breadth, based upon market profiles, is just a counter trend rally, and to expect that prices are going to continue lower.
And folks, if you want that information every trading day, real easy to get, come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content, Mastering Probability. You hit subscribe. You're going to have that newsletter on your desk tomorrow morning. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Steve, you have a great one, a safe one. Of course, we look forward to the program tomorrow.
Thanks, Tom. Take care.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow right now up 8, NASDAQ up 101, S&P's up 17. We'll come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all the TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now flat. NASDAQ is up 100. S&Ps are up 17.5. J.P. Morgan, folks, they're going to start bringing traders back in waves. Right now they're working at 20% capacity in their Manhattan offices at 383 Madison Ave. This announcement here saying that they're going to bring up the 50% of their sales team and trading team back by the middle of July. It looks like they're saying that, and this is how they're basically, this is the quote inside the press release, that they're going to bring volunteers back to 383 Madison Ave in waves starting June 22nd, ramping it up from the 20% of sales and trading staff to about 50% by the middle of next month. And it's going to be intriguing to see how they handle with the elevators. They have the elevators are going to be one of the hardest things, getting people into narrow situations, folks, going up and down. If you've ever been in, well, we've all been in large buildings. The bottom line is that we know the elevators, problems, period, because they're so small. But somehow they're going to figure out they're going to get this thing done. So what they are going to do is that, let's see, so the bank implemented a queue system for elevator banks and reduced capacity of elevators to ensure distance can be maintained. Employees are going to be required to wear a mask when walking through the communal areas on elevators and any other space that it would be hard to maintain distancing. Jamie Dimon, bottom line, was on the floor last week. That's what they're saying simultaneously inside of this issue. So we'll see how they basically work out. I mean, you know, when you're getting that many folks up and down an elevator, that can't be easy. There's no doubt about that. Market-wise out here, bottom line is that it looks like, you know, the Dow is going to have a hard time. You know, it looks like it's going to finish flat. But flat for the Dow out here today, folks, is a monster move. I mean, because what you do have, there's no doubt you get that rejection of lower price. Bottom line, see whether it can get any juice. As when we were just talking to Steve, the bottom line, he was talking about counter trend bounce. That's what happens, folks, in highly volatile markets. This move looks like it's extraordinary, but guess what? It is extraordinary if you bought and you were a bull this morning. It's not extraordinary when you go back 4 days ago. 4 days ago, bottom line, we're at 2,000 points higher in the Dow, or basically 175 to 180 points higher in the S&P. So NASDAQ, NDX, no doubt. Let's go look at the NDX as the strength versus the weakness. Inside the NDX, the strength, Zoom is up 8.5%. You get Dexcom up 7%. Tesla is up 6%, 993, and you get Electronica Arts up 3.5%. Taken away from it, big numbers, man. Well, not big numbers, really. Marriott's only down 2.5%. You get United off 1%. You get Ross Stores off 1.7, and Trip.com is down 1.5. Now, if we go over to United, what you're going to see out here today, United basically, you know, has some action, meaning I wouldn't be buying the stock, but what they looks like they are going to manage to pull off is that they're going to basically push out a $5 billion loan, and that's going to be the collateral on that is going to be their frequent flyer program. And if you remember, they were trying to push this out a couple weeks ago and into the public markets, and what had ended up happening is that the collateral then was their planes, and no one would bite. The broker-dealer community couldn't sell the bonds. It looks like they probably have, well, they have better collateral, because what happens with the frequent flyer program is this, folks. All the large banks buy the miles, pre-buy them off the airlines, and we're using our credit cards. That's what that's all about. What hasn't happened before is this. This was pretty cool. Inside their balance sheets, it's never been pulled out, actually, what the frequent flyer miles are actually worth to the airlines. So it's going to be interesting to see, because this will end up being public information, as to how much they had to put up, meaning in the frequent flyer miles, in order to secure the $5 billion. You know, so we'll see where that shakes out. But and the reason they want to do it this way, instead of going, well, they'll probably end up going with the government too, but in this way, the first loan of that $5 billion, they don't have the restrictions that if they go back to the government, the bottom line, the restrictions that are going to be on that is that you can't turn around and buy all your stock back, pay your CEOs $200 million to all of this, okay? So it's a big number. Hertz, HTZ, this one's going to get on the record books, no doubt, folks. We talked about it last week. Bottom line, Hertz got the okay to turn around from the court and sell 500 million in shares. 500 million, mind you, okay? Now, they made a deal with Jefferies, and this is going to be on an open market basis, folks. So an open market basis means that they're flat out. They can sell it in the open market, and as many as they sell, guess what? You've diluted the stock that much. And Hertz's case, this is the quote inside. Hertz stock buyers will need more than a miracle to avoid the wipeout. Inside of that, Hertz warns buyers they will need a miracle in order to avoid a wipeout, okay? So what we had out here today is that Hertz actually opened at $2.19. You're at 178 right now. And when this day started, okay, picture something, they were looking to raise $1 billion. 500 million times that 272 or whatever, or $2. The high was 272 out here today, of course, gets you over $1 billion. Well, now at 500 million, we're at 178. I suspect what we're going to see out here by tomorrow, you know, as they keep pushing this out here, you know, Hertz will probably be back to like 80 cents by tomorrow. That being said, guess what, folks? They will push the equities out now at any price there is. Why? Because guess what? You're pushing money in. It's unheard of that a bankrupt company that is actually in bankruptcy has pushed out equity, and that they had the clientele, meaning people, entities, would actually buy a bankrupt company. And that just goes to show, which is so sad, whether someone's in, you know, whether it's grammar school, high school, college, man, what I can't quite understand is that how do we have, you know, I'd say overall we have a great education system, big time. That being said, not a great education system for the financial business, and that's what everyone's working for, which has never made any sense to me. But you can see it, because guess what? If anyone had a class on what a bankruptcy actually is, and the amount of fees that get above and beyond inside of bankruptcy. As soon as you're inside of bankruptcy, folks, if you're doing, you know, they're going to be doing like, I don't know, 5, 10, 20 billion in bills. You get something like that, the attorney's fees alone are going to be 50 to 100 million, okay? So mark my words on this, okay? The bottom line is that it's going to be worth zero. Unfortunately, they can push it out to the public. That's going to be worth zero. And, you know, hopefully people are not putting their life savings in it. But after you read a couple of the stories into the Wall Street Journal last week, those stories there were saying that a couple of people were putting their life savings into it because they thought the brand was worth it. Dow up 61, NASDAQ up 121, S&P's up 22. Stay right there. Come right back, folks.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow is up 103. NASDAQ's up 127. S&Ps are up 25. And I'm going to stay with Hertz. Just a quick one here, folks, because this is also inside the prospectus. Now, this is about as intense as you can get. So we can see where they stand right now, they've already filed this with the court. Between now and August 21st, folks, okay, they have $1.2 billion in bills, okay, just as an operating aspect. I'm not talking about a catch-up. That's all it is. Then they have $2.3 billion that's underwater in their bonds that they haven't paid because they're not paying from now until July. They're supposed to stop paying in August again, so they have that. And now here's the kicker, though. All their collateral, okay, is tied up inside of their cars. Well, what also happens is this. Inside of the cars, you have secured debt from all those cars. Well, what happens there, all those bondholders are worth owed huge amounts of money. And then on top of that, you know what the Hertz has been doing, folks? The bottom line, they need cash so bad that they're selling off fleets on a continual basis. And they're selling off fleets. This is Hertz saying this. They're selling off fleets at approximately $1,389 below market value for their cars. And they that's in the wholesale market. The retail market, they figure that's 43% lower than what the market is at this particular point. Why? Because they need cash. So you can see what that right there is pretty intense in itself, because the fact of the matter is, you know, you need cash. Doesn't matter. I got 1,000 vehicles here. Take the 1,000 vehicles. Here's the discount. That's over. Now, on top of that, though, this is where the kicker comes. You got to remember that someone has the collateral on the other side. And so as they do that, they got to basically pay, and I'm sure they're losing hand over fist. So it's the rest of those bonds that are still out there that have the collateral for the vehicles. Guess what? $1 billion is going to go nowhere for Hertz. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you'll bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you, folks. You might as well have a blast with it. Come back and visit us tomorrow morning. TFNN, 8:30. Tommy kicks us off. Great show. Yeah, go get him, folks.